Hello, my name is Sameer Pratap Singh. I am a technical marketing engineer in the NetSec team at Cisco. In this video, we will talk about the Performance Estimator tool and see how to use the tool. The Performance Estimator tool allows the user to calculate the estimated load on different secure firewall appliances based on the traffic that the appliance is expected to receive with varying network conditions in the customer environment. To use the tool, log into the dashboard. The user has option to select router interface mode or inline pair mode and then enter the expected throughput that is to be observed by the device. The slider can be used to set the throughput or it can be entered manually. The user can select the average packet size for the throughput test numbers among default, small, data sheet number or enter a custom value. There are a number of features that the user can select based on their customer environment, which include option to only see the snort 3 numbers in the tool output. The user can select different features that would be used, such as AVC, IPS, URL filtering, and AMP. The other option that the user has is to provide information if there is TLS traffic that is decrypting on the firewall and if the firewall will terminate any VPN traffic. We can use the slider to set the amount of traffic being decrypted and the amount of VPN traffic that is expected to see on the device. Under the advanced filter section, the user will have the several options to filter out the output, selecting the model series, power supply option, interface types, and operating system. There is also an option to show the end of service devices if the user wants. So let's put in some values, select some features, and take a look at the output. We select routed mode, set the throughput as 5 GB, and select base and IPS features. In operating system, we select FTD and click on apply. Now, user has the option to only view devices that fall within a certain load percentage, the default being from 40 to 80, or select 0 to 200, to see all the devices within that range. The output displays list of all the devices and the load utilization for them based on the input provided by the user. So for example, for the device 3110, with snort 3 enabled, the load utilization is 49% for the given input throughput and parameters. It also displays the estimated logging value for the device and the estimated event rate. The tool allows increasing the quantity of the device and that will increase the estimated logging volume and event rate. The tool also provides load utilization of cluster units. So for an 8-unit cluster of 3110, this would be the load utilization. In case of single node, it also displays the number of nodes needed in the cluster to comply with the load utilization requirement. Another feature added to the tool is the compare performance feature. This allows the user to view the load utilization of different versions of each FTD appliances side by side to get an idea of how much the performance has improved from one version to another. To use this, under advanced filter in the compare version option, select the FTD version that you want to compare with and click on apply. This will display both the version next to each other with their estimated load utilization for the users to compare. It will help the user in making a decision as to which version to go forward with. Next, we have the logging volume estimator tool. We log in going to the tool section and selecting the logging volume estimator. It calculates the estimated logging data volume based on most common traffic mixes and network conditions for an average deployment. There are two methods of calculating the logging volume. First is to select an appliance and set its quantity. Additionally, the tool allows setting the load on the appliance too. The result gives the estimated event rate and the estimated logging storage required. The other option is to enter the daily combined event rate and we get the same parameter in the result. The average throughput calculated is the minimum upload bandwidth that is needed to the cloud for lossless log transmission. It is recommended to do the sizing above the average throughput to account for peaks in traffic. The third tool is used to provide an estimated RAVPN throughput for different appliances, with scenarios covering TTLS and IPsec IQ V2 for 1024 bytes and 450 bytes traffic. To use it, go to More Tools and select RAVPN numbers. Select the model, and the data for that model will be displayed on the tool. We also currently have 4200 pre-release numbers for version 7.4 that can help users in selecting the hardware based on the estimation provided by the tool. This brings us to the end of this video. I hope it was useful to you, and thank you.